Hello and welcome. So today I'm doing the Facebook Live solo in my kitchen with my vision board that I need to update behind me. I hope you can hear me. Please give me a shout out to say if you can hear me, if you're online. I always love knowing that people are there and that you can hear me okay. So today's topic is a pre-Christmas topic, and that is that, many of us are going to be around family and maybe family we haven't seen in a long time, and it's been a very stressful time for many people this year. Some people have found this year a blessing, other people have found aspects of it stressful. There's very different disruptive energy levels going around. And invariably, if you're in business or startup or you've got a side hustle, someone's going to ask you the question, "So, how's business going?" Now, the question then is, how you answer that and what you do about it, about that. So let's set the scene. Most of us love our family very much, but many of our family members can be quite triggering in some ways. I think we know that. Hello, lovely Trish, sending you a wave. And there's always some family relatives in any dynamic, or maybe you're lucky not to have one like this, but there's usually someone who will just be, just that little bit boastful. It might be a brother-in-law with a brand new car, he just wants to talk about his car, or someone who's got a promotion at work, or he's got lots of money, or just wants to talk about, lots of sort of stuff with themselves. And it's usually that same sort of person who's going to come and say to you, "So, how's business?" And so, let's go through some tips about how to go through this. I guess the first thing I wanted to say is that my experience is that most people really just want to talk about themselves. Quite frankly, that's just for a lot of people, that's where they're at. When I first came to Canberra in 2000, and for many years after that, I was working in some fairly confidential roles, or some roles that, had access to a lot of confidential and, in fact, secret information. Which many people I know on here are from Canberra and who work in government or who have partners who work in government. So you hear what I'm saying. So you become accustomed to not talking about what you do because you can't talk about what you do. You can't share. You can't go to a barbecue and actually talk about what you're doing. Actually, funny story that one person I know said that he'd actually been to a job interview with one of the secret services. I think it was with ASIO, and it's a condition that you don't talk about that process. Anyway, he'd gone to a barbecue and he'd had a bit of a joke about it, and then he moved away from the main people and someone came up to him and said hello, and he realized it had been someone he'd met through the interview panel. So needless to say, he didn't get that job. We all laughed about it, but it can happen. So I got very used about to not talking about what I did at that time because I couldn't do that. But and I was really worried about that initially. I was kind of like, what do people ask? What do people ask me what I do? Well, how am I going to answer? But the reality is a lot of people don't ask because they're more interested in talking to about themselves. So if you really do not want to talk about how your business has been going, if it's been a bad year for you, and you feel you can't handle that, just invest a lot of time into listening to them. They'll love you for it. They probably won't ask you many questions back in return, and you probably won't even have to ask this question at all. So, that's just something to keep in mind. So if they are asking you, they're probably just asking to be polite and they probably don't care about the answer. You can deflect back to them fairly easily saying, "Oh, how it's been, whatever, but I'm sure you felt that in your business," and they'll be off talking about themselves in no time. And so you won't even have to answer the question, at all. However, I actually think it's a really good opportunity to actually talk about your business. We often talk about elevator pitches in terms of other networking events, and I think it's a good idea to come prepared with a short elevator pitch. Now, what is an elevator pitch? This is assuming, say, you suddenly got caught in an elevator with someone you wanted to impress, a CEO, someone amazing, I don't know who it is, PM, whoever. You're stuck in the elevator with them, sharing an elevator with them for 10 seconds or 15 seconds or 30 seconds. You decide to make, you know, polite conversation with them, and they say, okay, so what do? And you tell them. And so you have a really nice, succinct story about what it is that you do. So many of the people on here who I know through networking circles such as Business at Breakfast or who've come to the Joyful Business Club events, you will know what this is. If someone says, what do? You are able to answer that, and you practice this. And there's quite an art to it, because you don't want to spend 10 minutes explaining how you make some widget. You want to be able to explain it in a couple of sentences where people can really understand what it is that you do and understand it in a positive way, not like over the top, I'm selling, a particular multi-level marketing product or Bible studies products, sessions or something that person might feel a bit, confronted by. You know, I'm really committed to, my passion is helping, for instance, if I was talking about the Joyful Business Club, I might say, well, I've started this new group for helping support women so that they can shine to their full potential. And I'm really, passionate myself as being in business about helping women in business. And my ultimate goal is to establish a microfinance mechanism to support women in business. Now, you get that, right? So, and you can get some of my passion. So that's what I mean by an elevator pitch. So it's worth actually thinking about one before you go into these holiday environments, and to have it ready. So when someone says, so what do? You know exactly how to answer that, and that's good. And I often like to think that any event is a networking event. We often pay money or time to go to a formal event, which is a networking event where we hand out networking cards and we hand out things. I think anytime you are talking to someone else, anytime you're interacting with someone else, anytime you're even sending an email to someone else, it is reflecting something of you. Particularly when you're at a family lunch where there's a whole lot of people there, I consider that a networking event. Now, this is not to say that you should or could spend the whole time talking about yourself, about, hey, here are my fabulous products. Why don't you buy? Why don't you buy whatever with me? It's not the time or the place to be doing that. And in fact, I wouldn't even do that at a networking event anyway, because, I mean, who really wants to be interacting with someone who's just talking about themselves and trying to push their products on you? It's not an effective communication strategy. But when you are there together with people, you know, it is a natural opportunity that people will want to know more about you and you'll want to know more about them. And so you never know who your next customer is. Misty Henkel, who was on last week, who's a sales and networking coach, she often says that our family often are the ones who know the least about what we do. And so you would think that your family would be your biggest advocate for your business, but often they're not, because they don't actually know what you do and you haven't had that kind of, interaction with them. I was speaking just earlier with two lovely ladies for a podcast that I'm doing. They both write at Keeping It Frugal, which is a fabulous blog, by the way. And they are also foodies with their Instagram channel, The Wonder Cooks, WANDERCOOKS. Anyway, the funny thing about this was I was mentioning it and one of them laughed and said, yeah, we ended up doing a whole heap of work for my ex-husband. And I was like, what the? So, these are, two ladies who got married last year. She's now done some work for her ex-husband. So the pair of them have. So you never know when a member of your family could actually be your customer or when they could recommend you to other people. So when you, actually do have that short, sharp, elevator pitch, if asked, or are able to interact with others when they ask this question, so how's business? And you tell them in an honest way what's happening, it could actually generate business for you in the weeks, months, or year ahead. I'd also say, too, that it is quite okay to give an honest answer because, quite frankly, for a lot of people in business this year, it's been shit. And so, if you're saying, oh, it's so fabulous, it's such a blessing and everything's fine, I've been able to pivot and it's wonderful, like, that's going to sound fake. That's not going to sound real, because that's not going to sound, they're going to know that this isn't real because they can tell from your body language and how you're talking about it. It will just be too over the top. So it's important to get that balance right between not being so totally depressed. You just sort of sit in a corner crying and people think, oh, well, her business isn't any good because, you know, clearly she's got nothing positive to say about it. Like, you know, I'd better stay away from that. You know, that they sort of, you know, you don't want to engender pity for what you're doing. You don't want to be so, you know, positive to the point where it doesn't sound real either. And you sort of, you just need to have that authentic answer. Probably the best one that I have found is the lovely Jocelyn Carter, who's a fabulous naturopath who I know through Business at Breakfast Circles. She wrote on the Joyful Business Club Facebook group yesterday, I think. She said, when she's asked this question, she says, going well, down on this time last year, steady, there's patients every day, all in all, it's going well. So you can see that flavor, right? She's admitted that, yeah, like, you know, I mean, she's in that service industry where she sees clients one-on-one. So obviously she's been COVID affected. A lot of her clients are not coming out so much. So, you know, it's obviously down on last year, but she's still seeing her clients. She's still passionate what she's doing. And overall, it's still going well. And I think that's actually a really honest answer that people can relate to. Like, you know, there's been challenges, but, you know, she's still going well and she's still really proud of what she does. And so that's it too. And I think it's important when giving that on an answer too that you don't dwell. Like you don't go on and on and on and say, oh, no, I don't know how we're going to keep going and blah, 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 blah. Like just don't go there. Just this is it. Like, you know, it's been challenging, but, you know, we're still going. We're still going. We're still doing well. Still seeing patients. Still seeing clients. Still committed to what we're doing. Still committed to what I'm doing. Overall, you know, it's doing well. You know, I've learned some lessons from this. We're moving forward. So how to balance that when there has been, you know, a very difficult time, how to balance that message with authenticity. I'd also add sometimes that we're often our worst enemies. We're probably doing really, really well, but we don't perceive it. And I think a key reason for this is that success is so much more than dollar signs. This is something that I struggled with because I don't know why I, you know, despite, you know, the fact that I knew this was not going to be true, but I thought I could just walk out of, you know, a well-paying public service career that I've been in for nearly 20 years and had spent nearly 20 years working up to and walk into an immediately highly profitable business structure. Now, of course, that doesn't happen even in COVID and bushfire years, right? And overall, I have done extremely well. And I know that because, you know, I'm proud of myself and I know what other people tell me and I've got the results for that. But still, I was finding myself beating myself up because I wasn't, you know, producing that same amount of profit yet. So I just want to say to you that success is so much more than dollar signs. Success is different things to other people, but to me, I think it's about living according to your values, and it's also about helping others and the value of influence. I am very proud this year that I've been able to help a lot of people with my writing, and with my coaching, with my courses, and that I've really been able to spread that message of financial resilience on the Joyful Frugalista and on the Joyful Business Club, that I've also been able to help a lot of people really align with their dreams and where they want to be. Now, to me, those sorts of things are priceless. When I read, you know, the comments that people send me often about how they feel after they've read my book or they've listened to my podcast and they've got those aha moments, I know that what I do is important. And to me, that is success. It's nothing to do with the dollar signs. It's a whole bigger picture of these things that's happening. And it's also quite normal, even not in a bushfire and COVID year, that startups and businesses take time. They do take time to grow. And it's often not a direct line. You know, it's two steps forward, one steps back. You make a mistake, something doesn't work, you try again in a different way. You invest in something that doesn't work, you try again in a different way. They refer to it often as pivoting or being agile. And I know some people have heard those words so much this year, they're completely over it. But, you know, that's the reality for someone who's in business or an entrepreneur. In order to be successful in the long run, you need to be, you know, able to be flexible in the short term. So if you haven't reached this ultimate dizzying success where you feel you can go to, you know, Christmas and everyone will automatically fall at your feet because they've seen you in the media, they've, you know, seen your big new car and, you know, they can see how successful you are, Yeah, look, I think that's probably not going to happen anyway. Like, because, success in terms of that, long-term financial success takes a lot of time anyway. And in any case, I'd be a bit concerned for, your own mental well-being if you felt you needed to kind of boast that much amongst family and friends. But I guess some people do, right? But just knowing yourself, success is so much more than dollar signs. And also, no one really knows other than the tax man, the ATO, and your tax accountant, maybe your bookkeeper. No one actually really knows how much you're earning anyway. So, it's just an internal discussion you've got within you. All people will see is how you represent yourself. They'll see your body language. They will hear how you speak about your business. They'll see how you feel in yourself. So, pay attention to your body language too. Keep that positivity when you are talking about your business, so that people can see that sense of that passion and that drive that you have, and what it is that you do, and how fabulous you are. Just let yourself shine. Noting, of course, it's not Christmas lunch is not about you being on the stage. You are one of the many actors or one of the many players in it. It's quite okay to allow yourself to shine, but make sure you listen to other people too. And on this topic too, beware the alcohol. It's been a really difficult year for a lot of people, and I know I keep saying this, but I've just had an event, family event, where there was alcohol involved, and it didn't go well. I'm not a big drinker; I never have been. I've recently been doing some work with the Foundation for Alcohol Research and Education, so next year there'll be some videos that will go around talking about how I'm reducing my alcohol, and I'm genuine about that anyway. Like I said, I've never been a big drinker, but I'm going to be making a conscious effort to really reduce and probably even go without for a period of time to send a signal, because I do think that drinking alcohol is such a problem in Australian society. Not blaming anyone, because it's just part of so endemic to our society, and people do it in for many different reasons, including women, and so tied up with how we manage stress and socialization and a few other things. But if you're already feeling a bit like, it's been a really difficult year for you, and you're not sure kind of, how to handle these sort of questions at Christmas time, you're feeling a bit insecure of your business, just really, be careful of your alcohol consumption, because it'll be so much easier to manage these types of questions, to look professional, to sound professional, with love while you're there with your family, when you're not totally, inebriated and you haven't had too much to drink. You will feel so much better. You'll present in such a better way. Go home and have a glass of sparkling if you want, but try not to do it in front of your families. And on a final point, if you feel that your family is especially triggering, sometimes it's better just to stay away from them. I know that's revolutionary, right? How would anyone dare to say that in Christmas when you have to be together? It's all about family unity. Well, you don't. There aren't rules. And if you know you're likely to get into an argument with someone, or if you know you're going to find it really hard to deal with questions from your seemingly successful family, and to be honest, you really don't know. Just as they don't know how much money you've got in the bank, you don't know how much money they've got in the bank. And what they're spending doesn't necessarily represent what they're saving, investing. You don't really know their true story, their financial situation. You don't know that if they're boasting about their money or their success, whether it's real or not. You don't know. That's their journey. All you've got is your journey. But if you're going to know you're going to be around people on Christmas who are going to be triggering for you, especially in your startup and your early stage, well, stay away from them. Offer to do the dishes. Off, go and play with the kids. Stay away from those people as much as possible. Don't get into a discussion with them if you can. If you feel you really can't handle them, even despite, trying to make yourself scarce and not sitting near them and not dealing with them, and spending all the time, doing the background stuff to avoid interacting, just on Christmas Day, just say, I've got a sore throat and a cough, and because of COVID, I really think I need to maintain a bit of social distancing. Might seem cruel, it might seem wrong, but it's a hell of a lot better than you feeling triggered by this and then, coming away with a big sense of guilt or self-doubt, doubting what you're doing, or maybe even giving up your business plans. So I guess just to finish, just remember that what you're doing is special. Like, everyone has their own path. Everyone is shining in their own path. It's normal to feel a sense of self-doubt, and it's hard when you're around family who may not get the bigger picture of what you're doing. Like, when you have reached that point where, if that success is more obvious, they'll get it, but in the early phases, they probably don't. And if they've had a background story that hasn't been about being an entrepreneur or taking risks, they're probably not going to get it. So, if it's normal that, these things might be a bit difficult, but it's also quite okay to be positive about, what you are doing with your business. Have a script that's ready so that you can share with a bit of positivity the passion you have for what you do and why it's important. Use that opportunity, if asked, as it flows within a conversation, noting the importance of listening to other people rather than, just grandstanding yourself. But, it's quite okay to use it as an opportunity to, talk about what it is you do and why it's important to you. And you never know how that could end up being a really positive thing in terms of, customers and clients down the track. Thank you so much for listening. I'd love to hear your stories about whether this is something that is difficult or triggering for you on Christmas Day, whether it's something that, you dread, whether it's something you embrace, how you go about it, what your strategies are. And above all, I really wish you all the best for the festive season. I know many people had a difficult year this year. It's getting a lot better, and I'm really hoping that it'll be a whole new cycle in 2021. I'm wishing you peace, love, joy, and abundance. Thank you. Bye.